is the biggest mistake committed. Because a person heading, performing public health should be mature, should be willing to work in a rural area, should be very fluently communicative, should be willing to communicate with colleagues, he should not be arrogant or should not be having any superiority complex. He should be visiting fields very frequently, because health was defined by WHO. Do you know, anyone know what is the definition of health by WHO standards? It is not mere absence of disease. It is including physical, mental, spiritual well-being. That definition comes to close to our Ayurveda philosophy, not to allopathy. Allopathy never bothers about spiritual well-being or mental well-being. If the patient is mentally abnormal, we'll be happy. He'll be a patient lifelong for me and I can earn through out of him. Is it correct or not? Like lawyers. Once you are a client, always a client. Either his property should be sold out or he should die. Same thing with doctor also. So that definition comes nearer to Ayurveda. We have yoga. Probably, I think, now, not because I am in AVP, my wife is dead against AVP. Because her husband vanishes very frequently from home. She wants her husband to be by her side always. So he hates AVP. But for the past few years, he is very strict that the entire family should practice yoga. Unfortunately, after 70 years of independence, we have found out that one simple thing, yoga can prevent something. It is true. We have a huge creed of diseases called psychosomatic disorder. Psycho means psychological. Somatic means body. Diabetes mellitus, hypertension, obesity, osteoarthritis, gastric ulcer, irritable bowel syndrome. So many diseases are there. They are psychosomatic disorders. Unfortunately, allopathy never bothers about psychological component. Do you know why quacks are very happy and very famous in our country? If you go to a doctor, he will say, he will blame on law. He will blame on Supreme Court judge. He will blame on lawyer. He will blame on being Prime Minister of this country. The reason is our own doctors. They never want to open their mouth. They want to talk less. They feel that by communicating less, their respect is maintained. The quacks communicate very frequently, very freely, very efficiently. That makes the population attract towards quacks. So, the public health involves prevention of diseases. In that, our traditional systems may play a very big role. We are having a group of chemicals called phytochemicals like turmeric, neem or ginger. It is scientifically proved. Yeah, you are doing a PhD in?
Yeah, I am doing in anatomy, but I have used some herbal drugs.
Very rare to find a person who is doing PhD in anatomy. Okay. So, lot of phytochemicals are there. They are effective agents preventing cancer. That is scientifically proved. We add a lot of, now we eat pizza. Now, whenever I am having a doubt whether I am pronouncing that correctly or not. What is the pronunciation? Pizza or pizza? Whatever it is. I am very eager to eat the diet which I can't pronounce. You know, that is the aptitude of this country. Vipindra. I am just sharing my ideas. So this modern medicine never bothered about diet. The modern medicine, you eat more, you have disease more, you are happy, you come as patients. You have obesity, bariatric surgery. We have solution for everything. You don't bother. So we never had dietary control. We never incorporated preventive aspects. At least I will certify in a, I am a government gazette officer. I can write and put my seal. At least yoga will prevent your osteoarthritis, musculoskeletal system. So the people who went there to rural areas, they were very eager to do most sophisticated procedures. Everyone wanted to be a super specialist. Everyone wanted to do MCH. They were compelled to go to rural places. And that is the place you need more people. It is now inverted pyramid. Pyramid, you know, bottom should be wide and top should be narrow. In our country's health system, it is inverted pyramid. Bottom is heavy. Bottom is narrow. Tip. Top is heavy. Inverted pyramid is always unstable. Our manpower, our ambitions, our investment, our infrastructure, everything oriented towards super specialty hospitals, which cater a minuscule of population and a minuscule of diseases. And public health system, which needs huge manpower, which caters a huge population, was unattended, neglected, both in the form of human resources and in the form of investment. And a person going to rural area, you don't know. Actually, I used to say, don't blame Westerners. Starting from Macaulay education to our health, primary health system, center of health system, they were having some aim. Whether it is Macaulay education system or health education, whatever it is. It may not suit ours, but they had a aim. Ultimate goal for that system, even judicial system. They wanted to protect British, they wanted to punish Indians. But our country is capable of correcting everything. It is not our inherent nature, in between we had a capability. In the history textbook I have read, the Islamic Armada, which was conquering everything on its way, met its watery grave at Ganges. Some historian has written that. The Islamic Armada, which made its watery grave at Ganges, every scientific innovation will meet its grave in our country. Because we are capable of corrupting everything. At least the present generation. We have corrupted this health system also. You should speak about you. I will not. Then it will become contempt of court. I may be sued in court of law. So I will not discuss about your system. Okay. So we have corrupted everything. We have corrupted the health system also. As per WHO criteria, the job, you go and read the job function of a medical officer in a PSC. It clearly states that to gain confidence of common man, to claim obedience from him, the doctor should distribute and medicines at primary health center and treat some diseases. But the main purpose is not that. Main purpose is each primary health center should maintain the public health of 30,000 population with 6 sub-centers working under him, and he should make field visits every day. He should control epidemics. He he should find out epidemics, read the report to them. He should diagnose some diseases which needs referral, and he should ensure that the health indices are better in this country. Job function of medical officer in a primary health center very clearly states it needs 90% administrative skill, communicative skill, legal knowledge, interaction with the departments, everything, and only 10% medical knowledge is needed. Even that to gain respect and acceptance. Not that primary health center will treat all the diseases, but unfortunately now we are now as an inverted pyramid. We want the CT scan, we want MRI. Unfortunately, if I openly speak, it may be many people in power may be angry with me. The minister wants to supply MRI, 300 MRI machines in his state. Why? One MRI machine costs about 1 crore, and the kickbacks per machine was 20 lakhs. And 20 lakhs into 300, he can get that much of money. He gets machine and distributes to every primary center. There no one is capable of operating that. They are giving endoscopy to primary centers. They are giving sophisticated instruments to primary centers. They are constructing state of art operation theatres there. That is not the purpose of establishing primary health center in this country. Let 10% of people die if 90% of other people are going to live healthy way. That is the need of this country. It is very crude way. It is not, as a doctor, I should not speak like that. Even then, the priority is not to treat the very rare. When I was an MBBS student, I was confused whether I should become a physician, doing MD and treating a big stethoscope. How many times I will take stethoscope per day? Can you imagine? For 15 years, I have not touched this person, stethoscope. I am a surgeon. Because my medicine HOD, he described one heart disease is there, mitral stenosis. It is very rare and it is treated in a very sophisticated hospital. And it is one of the signs elicited by his stethoscope. He said, if we say zooming downwards during diastole, if I say that, he will give me a pass. That day I decided I will not be a physician. I don't have that much brain, I will become a surgeon. Why I am telling this? The teaching also has the same lacuna. You are trying to teach all sorts of very rare diseases. This country is bothered about, the country's media is bothered about Nipah virus. Who is bothered? H1N1 virus. You should bother. But they are all genetic because of genetic drift and genetic mutation of this H1N1 virus. Everything is genetic drift and genetic mutation of simple influenza virus. For any viral disease, the allopathy system doesn't have any answer. Just we support the patient. We don't have effective vaccines. And on that, you media and you government apparatus create a very big furor and invest money, very unfortunately. I don't support or I don't accept people dying of Nipah virus. But at the same time, your priority should be the health of 90% of people. In that Nipah virus AIDS, when I was student, they were telling the entire Indian population will die of AIDS. Because it's a very big virus, no treatment. You know, the AIDS virus will not survive outside human body even few minutes. That much labile virus we are bothered about, and even now we are living with AIDS. That much furor and funding were done for AIDS. We never taught moral behavior. We supplied in Europe. I don't know about this. I don't know what is the logic about this. Just because you are a lawyer and some of your colleagues is judge, you can't entertain, you can't encourage theft and murder, you know. It is like that only. Supplying Nirodh. You encourage that. More and more immoral activity, more and more Nirodh supply, and government is happy. 1 crore Nirodhs were effectively used in this country. What is this? You teach moral education. We never consider moral education as part of health in this country. Do you think the health ministry ever bothered about moral education? Do you think the health ministry here ever bothered about hygiene? Do you think, unfortunately, our Prime Minister is bothered about all these things? Like he says the antenatal mother's health is reflected in baby's weight and you should give consent toilet. For 70 years after independence, no health minister of this country bothered about constructing a toilet, bothered about maintaining hygiene, bothered about educating the population, bothered about moral education. And you speak and you aim something to achieve in health sector. How can you achieve that? Apollo came, so many hospitals came. We have giants. Do you know what is diabetes? It is poverty amongst plenty. The entire body will be loaded with sugar, glucose. But cells will not be having the capacity to use that. That is diabetes. The pathophysiology of diabetes is the body is not able to utilize for its own use the sugar produced in the liver. It is a disease of poverty amongst plenty. Same thing, we have this number of super speciality, so-called modern hospitals. We don't have enough people to pay for that. And now we are indulging in health tourism. What is health tourism, you know? Getting 20 lakhs from a poor Nigerian man, swindling 10 lakhs in between, and giving 10 lakhs here and getting him treated here. That is called health tourism. I see every day, you make the system corrupt and you are happy. You want that. One of my colleagues who left police job and joined a college professor who is state president of AVP in Tamil Nadu, he says, the police constables are made to commit mistake because then only his superior can control him. They were made to wait, write logbook for 24 hours. How a human being can have activity for 24 hours? They want you to do that because you will commit some lies there and your spirit always can catch hold of you. Like that, you want doctors and health system of this country to commit mistakes so that you can control them. I don't know. Nowadays I am hearing much about Lutyens Delhi. What is that? I don't know. Recently I heard that Lutyens was the person who designed the center of Delhi for the British capital. I don't know. But the interest of Lutyens Delhi was served when doctors and multi-speciality hospitals were committing mistakes because they can happen. Okay. If I time is there, I know the problem is when his sir was talking to me, it is a very big issue. It is an issue of 1,000 years. I can't speak in 1 hour. And also he said half an hour you speak and half an hour they will interact with you. I don't know. Okay, there is no quick fix solution is there for any problem. I move to the other part. What is the solution I think? My first solution will be, I don't know, any radical change here in this country is vehemently opposed, that is reflected in demonetization also. Whether it delivered or not, it is not a bad move. This is my status stand. No one had any corrupt practices in his mind when he implemented demonetization. Like that, this country needs some radical steps. One of the radical stuff I feel is you should separate the public health, entirely the public health, away from the curative health. The IAS officers, the department, the ministers administering the health education and tertiary health care centers should not be allowed to bother the which caters 80% of problems and population. But your health funding, health allocation caters 80% this sector, not that sector. So my personal opinion is you separate this public health sector away from this, because that way that gives you a solution. That need not man doctors. Whatever people trained, manpower trained, you can call them as barefooted doctor or thin ear doctor, whatever it is, you can man them. You can train people, you can train people in a way that suits the public health. The entire curriculum, I was forced to read so many syndromes, so many rare diseases, this dooming diastole, dooming downwards during diastole, but I never read what is administration, what is hygiene, how to interact, communicative skill, this and that. We never bother. So if you are going to separate that, you can install a very big, huge population of manpower without much opposition from the lobbying of IMA and all other bodies, because you don't call them as doctors. When you call them as doctor, I told you already, arrogance automatically comes into, the ambition automatically, yearn automatically comes into, the seclusion comes into automatically. He lives his own world. So don't call them as doctors. Whatever you want to call, you call. But separate that. Teach them how to treat basic ailments like fever, diarrhea, dysentery, that's all. Nothing, booming downwards, doing diastole will not be taught to them. What that some person is going to die of mental stenosis at the age of 60 years, with a, who is bothered? I should not talk as a doctor, but even then I speak. That department should not bother. This curative health you separate. And I assure you, no insurance company, no private entity will be interested to invest in public health, because return, no returns. Who is going to gain if the infant mortality rate is going to come down? Who is going to gain if the maternal mortality has come down? I told you, no, more theft, more robbery, that I should not say that, yes, I should say advocates are happy. Like that, more number of cases, they are happy. So you invest heavy, the government investment should be very heavy. No return. Don't think it is a wasteful expenditure. It is an investment for future. Invest heavily. See that it reaches people. See that the end purpose is served. And elevate the public health level of this country. And entertain private players, philanthropists, multinationals in this curatively. No one is bothered. You can cover them with easily with insurance. That is number one. Number two, in all field of education, including medical education, we lack empathy. We lack any sense of nationalism. We lack social behavior, how to behave in a society. Teach them everything. Otherwise, don't blame doctors are not willing to go to rural areas. Doctors are not willing to serve people. Doctors are fleecing money when the poor patient is coming in pain. They will do that because you have made it an industry. So teach them something, moral values. That is what ABP is also bothered about. Teach them how to have some empathy on society. When in 2001, I did an appendectomy. My quote for the surgery was just 20,000. And my fees was 5,000, including my wife's fees, who is an anesthetist. And she paid 3,000. And at the end of discharge, she said, "Sir, I will sell these earrings and give it to you." And I said, "No, madam, what do you want? Leave it." Unfortunately, much of doctors are not having this attitude. I never, when I visit Northeast, I tell Northeast ABP people and all those, you develop cancer facility there. You develop confidence in among your population there, so that they will not come to Chennai for cancer treatment and spend their fortune. Fortunately, I was in ABP. I have been in ABP for 32 years. Whenever I see in Tamil, a movie called Ravan came. In Mani Ratnam movie. That movie was some erratic movie, forget about that. But the essence is, each human being is having a Rama inside him and Ravan inside him. In mind one corner, each human being wants to snatch away other man's property and wife. But another corner, Rama is sitting there. The Rama is always controlling Ravan. When Ravan takes over, he becomes a criminal. When Rama is on control, he is a good citizen. So, ABP by my association with a lot of organizations are there. I don't claim ABP is the only organization that will solve the problem of this country. I am not that kind of person. I am not attached to the 2-4 words ABP. For me, general well-being, general morality and general behavior of community behavior is more important than that 4 words. If you are going to name that organization in some other way, I will accept. Many ways you can get all these moral values. Even judges can get, even advocates can get. And since fortunately I was there in ABP for 32 years, the Ravan in my, from my corner, I kept him in one corner. I don't say my mind is 100% Rama. If anyone is going to say, either he is ignorant, or he is an idiot, or he is bluffing. Okay. Someone will say, you switch off the light. In a crowd, you switch off the light, observe the behavior, then only you can judge people. In darkness, how human being behaves, that reflects his inherent moral value. So you develop some moral value, that is another solution I am giving. Third one, I don't know, I may be speaking against this present government. I don't have belief in insurance system. In one meeting I said, banking and insurance are the biggest fraud being committed on Indian society. Banking and insurance. Because we never had banks in our country. We never had insurance in our country. Even then, lakhs of houses were reconstructed in between war. How? This country had joint family system. Where the first brother will be an IAS officer. You know Saravana Stores in Chennai? I think you may. It's a very big concern. It's not Saravana Bhavan. There, in a rural hospital, worked and that hospital was taken care of one Rajaratnam. In their family, one was doing business earning crores in Mumbai. Another was having a big shop in Chennai, earning crores. This person was doing agriculture. The entire income was shared among them. That is a joint family concept. Even agriculture of this country, you can say in this way only. You develop, encourage joint family system. Where all money will be pooled together, spent for the needs of anyone and everyone, education including everything. Then you don't need banking, you don't need insurance. You agree or not? In this way I will say, you are doing this like that, whatever you want you eat. Whatever disease come I will manage. I am happy because I am going to earn. If you are going to gain 140 kg, okay, come, I will do bariatric surgery. If you are going to have regurgitation, come, I will do some fundoplication, I will do some surgery. You don't, if joint family system doesn't suit you, okay, leave it. That causes more problems of this country. I will tell you, the joint family system may solve, I am not sure, it is like demonetization. The joint family system may solve many problems of this country.